And you looking forward to the celebration tonight?
You bet. It's a nice way to culminate the season. I remember in 80 when we did it, and it was a lot of fun then, and it's something to remember for years to come.
I know you're looking forward to two other things, too, fishing and golf.
That's right. I don't know when that's going to be able to start, but I'm anxious. It's been a long season, regardless of whether you win or lose.
We're glad to have you here, and Van, we had an exciting night and have an exciting program tonight.
That we have, Don. They said this crowd might need a warm-up. I think this town is red hot. We don't need a warm-up. We're bringing you a championship. It's good to see all of you here and come home and celebrate with you, because I hear you were celebrating last night. In fact, as soon as it's over, I'm going to go out and dance on a car myself.
Well, it's called a Cardinal Celebration. We're glad you're with us tonight. And for our listeners and viewers, we're going to be gone for a couple of minutes. We'll be glad to have you back for some excitement here in Freedom Hall. For those of you here, we invite you to watch our video screens. We have some special treats there tonight. Thanks for being with us very much tonight.
Say this much, you're getting warm. My name is Jack Tennant, and guess what I get to do? I get to introduce the 1986 NCAA champion.
I want to tell you, that's the band that smoked them in Reunion Arena. Boy, we blew Duke out of the building. They were incredible. Yeah. Those of us who were in Dallas for the past four or five, how many days has it been, felt a very special chemistry that seemed to come from where we were. We knew that you who weren't with us were with us. And that chemistry is spread all across America. And coming home to Kentucky to share this celebration with you are two of our favorite sons. Senior Senator from the state of Kentucky, the Honorable Wendell Ford. Say hello. Native son, very proud of his alma mater, Congressman Ron Mazzoli. Say hello. I want to tell you, there aren't many people in America who have logged as many air miles in the last week as your next speaker. Not only are we winding down to the final critical days of the legislature, not only does she have the Commonwealth of Kentucky to run, but she wanted to bring special, hang on a second, she wanted to bring special greetings, hang on a second, she wanted to bring special greetings to the Cardinals. Our governor came all the way to Dallas to let the Cardinals know that the Commonwealth of Kentucky was behind them. I want you to know that the governor came down Saturday and spoke to the pep rally and told him she's proud of the team from Kentucky who is representing all of us in the Final Four. She came back home to take care of some business and came down Monday to lead them on to victory. Ladies and gentlemen, the governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky, the Honorable Martha Lane Collins.
Of Kentucky, I want to say how proud I am of the way they represented Kentucky. I've been saying as I traveled the state that I wanted Kentucky to be number one. I didn't want us to take a back seat to anybody. Louisville is number one. I think it's fair to say that not a better freshman center in the United States than Purvis Ellison. They did. As a special word for the seniors and for what they've accomplished, not just last night, but for 4 years. Jeff Hall and his playmaking and outside shooting. And during the second half, Dawkins certainly did want you to go away and stay away. And Billy Thompson and his all-round abilities. A very good game, but I disagree with that because he was just waiting for the last 2 seconds. There's not a cooler player than Milt Wagner. Now, we're going to miss watching all these seniors play, but I'd say we have plenty to look forward to because after watching Ellison and Kimbrough and Crook and McSwain and Walls team up,
you to give a big round of applause to the University of Louisville's number one fan, President of the University of Louisville, Dr. Donald Swain.
It's been a wonderful week for the Cardinals and for the University of Louisville. All of us are tremendously proud of our Cardinals. And like you, I'm here to say thanks to them. So let me say thanks for being such great players. Thanks for representing U of L and indeed all of Kentucky so well. Thanks for all the thrills you've given us this year. Thanks for your commitment to excellence. And thanks for the priceless moments you've given us. As Governor Collins told you earlier this afternoon, we had a wonderful 3 sessions in Frankfort with the Senate, the House, and the Governor all honoring in separate ceremonies the Cardinals, the 1986 champions of the NCAA. We appreciate that very, very much. We're grateful that Congressman Mazzoli, Senator Wendell Ford are here. I want also to note that another Cardinal fan who can't be here tonight, Senator Mitch McConnell, called me just a few minutes ago to send his regards. And I know that Senator McConnell, Senator Ford, and Congressman Mazzoli will be working hard together to arrange a meeting with President Reagan for a proper party in Washington for the Cardinals.
Well, these guys are well-traveled, aren't they? The next speaker is a fellow who's had a love affair going with the University of Louisville forever, as a student and an athlete, as a coach, and now the man whose hand is guiding the fortunes of the athletic program for the university, and the guy who brought us all together tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, athletic director for U of L, here's Bill Olson.
Thank you, Wayne. This is called a Cardinal celebration, but before we came out tonight, we discussed what it really should be called, and from behalf of Denny Crum, our coaching staff, our team, our athletic department, we want you to know that this celebration is really a fan appreciation night. All of us want you to know how much we really appreciate the great Cardinal class of you, the fan support that we've had starting in Ogden 19 days ago when we started this destination toward Dallas and the national championship. There were only 250 tickets available in Ogden, We had almost 1,000 fans in Ogden. Thank you for that. We went on to Houston, and we had 750 tickets available. We had almost 2,000 fans in Houston. Thank you for that. And then we went to Dallas. Most of you, or a lot of you that are here, have driven back or came back on the charters. You'd be proud of the Cardinal fans in Dallas. We had 1,700 tickets. There were almost 5,000 fans representing Louisville in Dallas, Texas. Wayne Perkey referred to the chemistry. It does take a special ingredient to win a national championship or win a championship at any level, whether it's little league, high school, professional sports, or college sports. That chemistry is good coaching. I think in Denny Crum and Wade Houston, Bobby Dotson, and Jerry Jones, we've got the finest coaching staff in America. Takes good players. This team, I think what they've accomplished, it speaks for itself. They've been able to win against all kinds of competition this year, the greatest schedule that the University of Louisville's ever faced. This team has taken that challenge on and then come home with the national championship. So we know we've had a good team. And then it takes the fans. You know, the University of Louisville has won 4 national championships now. We've won the NAIB national championship in 1948, and then the NIT in 1956, and then our first NCAA championship in 1980, and then the second one here in 1986. We're the only team. We're the only team in America that has accomplished that at all levels. Thank you very much for helping us make it happen.
Thanks, Bill. Good job. And now the best color man in America. Ladies and gentlemen, with a white hat, here's Jock Sutherland.
I tell all of you out there, hell, it don't get no better than this. I feel like Billy Graham, and I might ask you to come forward in any minute, I'll tell you. I get the job of introducing, as Bill Olson said, the best coaching staff in the whole world. And the first guy I'm going to introduce is the guy who brought us the guy from Westwood, Kentucky, that said, "Good night, Johnny Dawkins, Coach Bobby Dotson."
We've known all year long who had the best fans in the country, and that's you people right here. You know, they have these polls that come out every week that says Duke's number one or North Carolina's number one. They never had the Cardinals number one all year. But when it came down to the time that it really counted, these guys stepped forward and proved for you, the greatest fans in the United States, who was number one. That's the Cardinals. Thank you.
The next coach is truly a great recruiter. The guy who slipped into Savannah, Georgia, and brought us a little old skinny kid, Wade Houston.
I'd like to also thank all the fans that are here today and the fans that follow us all year long. And I'd also like to thank the players that performed so well all year long. And they always told me that to be the best, you have to beat the best. And this team beat the best all year long. It's really amazing just to win one national championship. I've got one ring on this hand. I'm waiting for my other ring on this hand. Thanks, everybody.
last, but certainly not least, the guy we all call J.J., Denny Crum's right-hand man, and what else needs to be said about that, Coach Jerry Jones.
Thank you. I know I don't have to say anything about those guys back there. They know how I feel about them, and all of you, and you people that went to Ogden and Houston and Dallas, you know, you were great, and we saw all of you. But I'll tell you what, for all of you people that weren't there, we played our guts out for you, those guys did down there, for the people back home. I'd like to express, I know, your feelings as well as mine. We know all those guys that get in there all the time and play the 33 to 35 minutes. But to have a good basketball team, it's like a chain. You're only as good as your weakest link. And the guys that didn't play a lot, and for a lot of people that don't know, we have four seniors. Robbie Valentine. Place in the world to coach basketball, and I know for a player. God bless y'all.
Asked him to stand. First of all, the guy is kind of new with the basketball program. He is the strength and conditioning coordinator, Doug Semenek. Doug? There he is right here. Now, he tries to make them strong, and if anything happens to them that they can't make it, this guy tries to get him back on the road, and a great, great trainer, Jerry May. Jerry?
And it's my pleasure to introduce more folks who are involved in a championship basketball team this year, graduate assistant coach Jeff Van Pelt. And volunteer assistant coach Jack Ford. And a young man who did a heck of a job of helping getting the Cardinals there all the way to the championship this year, our manager, Jeff Witt.
Okay, some of the players will not get an opportunity to speak because they've got some time coming in the years ahead. We want you to meet the beginning of next year's championship team. First of all, a redshirt freshman from Louisville, Seneca, Keith Williams.
And freshman forward, David Robinson.
Another freshman forward, Avery Marshall.
And a freshman guard, Jock and I call him KW, Kevin Walls.
We got this one from Mississippi, Kenny Payne.
And a freshman guard forward who played like a senior last night, Tony Kimbrough.
I know this young fellow is one of Jerry Jones's favorites because he said he works hard, practices hard, and plays hard. Will Ologes.
By the way, Will, we did wish your mom happy birthday last night. All right, sophomore guard, Mike Abram.
A fellow that's been around a couple of years, a tremendous all-around athlete, Chris West.
And another guy that came back from hardship this year and had quite a game in the championship, junior forward Mark McSwain.
And here's a guy that doesn't play for anybody. Well, yes, he does. He plays for WHAS, Terry Miners.
Hi, everybody. I want you to say a special hello to Dr. Burt Monroe, a guy who works very hard to promote the University of Louisville Athletics. Dr. Monroe. There were so many Cardinal fans down in Dallas, there were not enough hotel rooms to go around, and we had to pile in, some of us 14 and 15 in a room, and if you came late, you were really stuck. The next guy that comes up here was really in a bind because he didn't get down until Saturday morning and ended up having to spend the night sleeping on the diving board out by the pool. Your mayor, Jerry Abramson.
What a great time to be mayor of Louisville. I mean, let me say three quick things. First, being down there Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, there are two organizations that you need to say thank you because they really made it special. The cheerleaders and the pep band. All right. You guys are great. Second, today we decided that we would put up 20 signs around the city designating this community as the home of the national championship basketball team. The first one went up today at 2nd and Main. The reason was because there's a coach up the road about, oh, I guess 100 miles, over in some other state north of us, that was wearing a button that said Duke. Now when those Hoosiers come over the river, the first to see is this. Finally, last but not least, you know, there's been a lot of people, coaches, broadcasters, they're all trying to tell us who the number one basketball coach in the United States is. Now, you know who sent a team to the Final Four in the 1980s four times. You know who won the NCAA in the 1980s two times. He may not be the coach of the year, but he's the coach of the decade.
It's going to be a tough act to follow here, but Mayor Abramson's predecessor is County Judge Harvey Sloan, a longtime promoter, backer of the University of Louisville. Please welcome him now.
We've got to be the proudest community in the United States tonight for one good reason, the Louisville Cardinals. They were underdogs, but they had the spirit, the competitiveness, and the class to come out as the champions, and that's what they are. Muhammad Ali talked about the greatest. I'll tell you who's the greatest. Denny Crum is the greatest, and never forget it. And as people come into this community on highways, as they come into the airport, as they come into the bus terminals, they're going to see the signs of the Cardinals, the champions in 1986.
We, of course, are going to hear words from Coach Crum in a few moments. A very popular T-shirt last summer that a few people wore in Dallas this past week showed a picture of Coach Denny Crum on one card and Coach Howard Schnellenberger on the other, and the words say the best two cards in the deck. We're going to bring those two cards up here now. Coach Howard Schnellenberger has a special presentation for Coach Crum.
Thank you very much. Really my pleasure, and I'm very fortunate to be here tonight and to have been selected to represent all the other coaches, both head coaches and assistant coaches at the University of Louisville, to come down here tonight not only to congratulate Denny Crum and this great basketball team, but more importantly to thank him for the terrific inspiration, the terrific leadership, and the terrific job that he's done, one which all of us are going to try our very best to emulate and to be like. As I come out on this stage here tonight, I know now why I came home to be in Louisville, Kentucky. We looked around to try to find something that would demonstrate how we feel about Coach Crum, his staff, and this fine football team. We couldn't really find anything other than something very, very simple that I think says it all. The best coach, the best team, the best university, and the best community, the number one team of all.
University of Louisville athletic program. Well, this season, Mickey kept having to rewrite it because the Cardinals kept winning more championships. We got to hear the final version of the 1986 Cardinal Cannonball on a plane back from Dallas last night. And now here he is to sing it for you. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Mickey Clark.
Thank you. Just want to thank all the local radio stations and TV stations that have been so supportive on this song. They helped make this happen. This community has such a great spirit, and everybody's a part of it.
We beat Drexel and Bradley and Ogden and hit with a roar. We tamed the Tar Heels and Auburn's Tigers to make the Dallas Final Four. We stopped LSU and made the Final Two and then turned Duke away and did our two-step across Texas to win the NCAA. is blocking shots, running up the score. With the Iceman, Milt's hot shooting, and cool under fire, Jeff Hall. We won it all down in Dallas on the Cardinal Cannonball. The card started slow till Billy rolled and Milt's shot came around. Just a freshman, he showed us what a gem we found. Then Tony and Kenny started coming on, and Kevin helped us beat DePaul. Herb's a perv, and Mark's a spark on the Cardinal Cannonball. Oh, they'll set your spine a tingle as they fly above the floor. There's Billy T. Herb and Purvis blocking shots, running up the Iceman, Milt's hot shooting, and cool under fire, Jeff Hall. We won it all down in Dallas on the Cardinal Cannonball. Well, here's to Robbie, Mike, and Avery, Chris, Will, Keith, and David, too. Coaches Jerry, Wade, and Bobby, Jerry May, Dr. Ellis, and all of Danny's crew. And here's to the fans who wear the red, they're the greatest fans of all. They help keep the wheels a-moving on the Cardinal Cannonball. And here's to our great coach, Denny Crowell, may his name stand forevermore. And it's the fourth time now in 7 years the Cards made the Final Four. Now when it's tourney time, they always shine, we knew they'd heed the call. And win it all down in Dallas on the Cardinal Cannonball. Well, they'll set your spine a tingle as they fly above the floor. It's Billy T. Herb and Purvis blocking shots, running up the score. With the Iceman, Milt's hot shooting, and cool under fire, Jeff Hall. We won it all down in Dallas on the Cardinal Cannonball. We reached our destination, Dallas on the Cardinal Cannonball.
Congratulations, Cards.
Had a great job, Mickey Clark. All right. I got to tell you about a phone call I got from my mother this morning in Lexington. She said she was afraid the world was coming to an end because when she went out this morning, the sky was no longer blue. The sky was red. It's a great privilege for me to get the opportunity to introduce a couple of our super players to you. That's a real privilege for me. The first guy, when practice started this year, nobody ever expected him to be out there when they introduced the starting lineup. We called him the other forward. Van and I call him the rubber man. He's the guy that carried us for Houston, Texas at the West Regional, Herbert Rubberman Cook. Before the game, I talked with Mrs. Ellison. I said, what's the greatest thing that Purvis can do? And she said, play the trombone. I said, he must be one hell of a trombone player. the MVP of the Final Four, Purvis, never nervous, Ellis. Support and just like to say, I hope to see y'all in New Orleans next year. And y'all got heard for 2 more years.
I'm sure I speak for the whole entire team when I say, instead of the trophy, reading the University of Louisville National Champions, it should read.